the Spirit empowered the church, and the Spirit continues to grow it. The Spirit empowered the mission of the church, and the Spirit continues to spread it. The Spirit deepened the unity of the church and calls us to partner with Him in this ministry of reconciliation.
In my team, we try to see what we can do, especially when we speak about the conflict between the Russia and Ukraine. We try to bring people around the table and start to talk, but we need to make the step for each other. And when we listen to each other, try to understand we are God's creation. And God put us in a different places for several reasons. We must be ambassadors in our countries, but when we come together, we need to accept each other.
And we can go on rescuing people. We can bring refugees, we can help everybody. But if there isn't a community of believers, then it's very hard.
I think one of the things coming in for most of us was to make connections with as many people as possible. And I've had some really amazing things happen. I'm moving to Athens, Greece in February. And so second night I was here, I said, Lord, I need to meet with someone who works with refugees in Athens, Greece. The next morning I got on the bus and I was listening to a conversation behind me, and it was a girl who had moved to Athens from Iceland to work with refugees in Athens, Greece.
But it is in our sincere, passionate, consistent obedience to Him that He will open the doors. There are big issues of our time, but our God is greater. And yes, we are not qualified, but that's totally fine, because it's not about you and it's not about me.
You must have seen our groups, both Indians and Pakistani, are having great time. We are happy to know each other. We don't want to just finish it off here. So we can have a regional meeting at a common place where we both can go and talk about reconciling with each other.
It is amazing that we are here, and there are so many fields, there are so many ways to connect here. It was a joy to be on the lab. I chose the table where it was education, and I met with brothers and sisters. Some of them were relative to ESL, English as a second language. And we already exchanged connections, and we are looking forward to continue to share information, because I believe it's the start of something that God is going to develop through all of these 10 years, or maybe through all of this life.
Being here at this conference has enabled me to make these wonderful connections with amazing people that share my heart, the heart to share the gospel. I met an awesome bluegrass band at my last meeting, and I found out that there could be a connection with us. Him coming to Israel for an Indian night that we host every year, and perhaps even to go up with us while our team goes into India, into the northern parts of India, and travel to share the gospel.
My one-on-one meetings have been amazing. My wife and I got to speak with our mentors. Both of them imparted the same messages into our lives. Firstly, you've only got one life to live, so go crazy, follow God's call, trust in Him. And second was, is both of them just imparted the message of Isaiah 42. And the fact that both of them said the same thing was really an encouragement and a confirmation for us.
When I joined the lab yesterday, the gentleman leading the session said to us that we needed not to share what the mission of our ministry or organization is, but rather he wanted us to write down what is our own mission. I was forced at that point to think about what God is asking me to do in my ministry, what legacy he wanted me to leave. And then as we continue the process, filling out the template, I realized that God is really asking me to leave a legacy of leadership. And as I sat yesterday, I realized that the lab gave me that specific opportunity to crystallize exactly what I needed to do in terms of mentoring staff and student leaders back home in Guyana.
Christianity without Christ, we never change Africa.
Is there any question that we are living at a momentous time in human history? Everything's information. So many people never get to knowledge, and even fewer get to wisdom.
In a context of the extreme materialism and the drive for success, many young Christians are not ready to pay the cost.